Real quick here, I wanted to share the progress of the solar cells. Right now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4.5 volts here in series. You can see the lead starting at the end. To the positive side, which is the bottom. And then they, you know, the top of the panels have the solder there, you know, they're all done like that. I got plenty of them laying around. I got a whole stack of them right there. I got more upstairs. The red electrical tape is used to cover the back of the piece. That's just over the solder point. I'm gonna have another row, another two rows, and that'll be 12, 13 and a half volts, almost 14 volts right now, but I'm sure it's more as an open voltage setup. I highly suggest you use a flux pen when doing this. Here's my rosin flux pen. I just got a new one. I didn't have another. My other one was empty. I didn't have one. I got it in the mail today, so here I am down here in the basement. You know, I use a butane soldering iron. That's my station right there. I use you know, Radio Shack rosin core. This is 63 series, whatever the hell I call it. I got another roll right here. You know, I got enough crap down here to build, you know, a lot of shit. this is one of the panels. I actually am gonna have more than two, probably two or three up there once they're all finished. But this is just to give you an idea. It's hard. It's a lot of patience, and these panels can break very, very easily. Here's actually a broken piece right there. That'll be used for another smaller project, but they break very easily. So patience is a virtue when building these suckers. What I'll do is when they're all done, I have another piece of styrofoam the exact same size as this. I'll put it down on top of this, flip them over, Slim Jims, and then flip them over, and then I'll be able to see the top of the completed, and then I'll be able to connect the series leads together, and then see how it works out. All right. If you got any questions, let me know. I'd be happy to answer any questions you might have. All right, thank you.